Everybody's here. Y'all, welcome back to Say Something. Of course, I am your host, Cheré, and today we're going to talk about the industry, the ins, the outs, the do's, the don'ts, the wows, all of it. It's industry beat talk today. But before we do that, I have to give you your 60-second get right. And so, for today, if you are feeling overwhelmed, if you're feeling frustrated, if you're feeling like you don't know why you're doing what you're doing, understand that when you have purpose inside of you, all of the drama, the naysayers, the chit, the chat, the distractions, they are gonna come at you because the devil can hear and see the same blessings that God has over your life. So what I want you to know, take all the drama, all the chit, the chatter, all of the distractions and let it drive what's inside of you, which is called your purpose. God didn't make a mistake when he created you. So understand that anything worth having is worth fighting for. So fight for what's yours. But of course, I could not do a show without one of my fabulous co-hosts here helping me out. So in the street beat talk today is going to be done with some of the best in the industry. Please help me welcome Mr. Cody Carrera and the country cutie, Rainey. Y'all came out dancing like y'all was ready to say something, right?
Right.
Why don't you go ahead and tell them what you do?
As you all know, I am the country cutie, Rainey Cakes. You can find me with WTNT's Q in the Streets each and every Tuesday from 7 to 10. I want to see you tuning in.
Tune in. And you?
And I am an actor and writer. Pretty self-explanatory.
That's Cody for you. So you see why I have them here to talk about the industry, the do's, the don'ts, the wows, and the oh-wees. So y'all stay right there because we're coming right back to talk about the industry on Say Something. Welcome back. Let's get this thing started. We're saying industry beat talk today, and you've met my co-host with me. We don't just interview, we talk about it. We say something. So, country cutie, Rain, Kate. See, you know, first of all, why that name? Why something that's going to twist my tongue completely?
Well, it was never meant to be a tongue twister.
I just made it that way.
Yeah, you made it a little difficult, but it's okay. My last name is Kate, and with that, I transitioned that to my radio name being Kate. But then I said, everyone else has like a little catchphrase. You got Charlemagne the God, and things of that nature. So I said, instead of putting something behind my name, let's put it in front of it. So I said, the country cutie.
The country cutie. It works out for you. I mean, I love it all. And I guess in radio, well, in the industry, period, yes, it has, you have your own identity, and it sounds good. I just, for some reason, can't get right with it, but I'm going to learn it by the end of today. I'm going to have that down pat.
Okay.
So that's my new challenge, to learn the
country,
Miss Kate's name by the end of the show.
You got it.
And then also, Cody Carrera, how are you?
Great. How are you doing?
I'm good. Are you excited to be here?
Oh, I am so excited. Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, thank you for coming.
It's an honor.
This is a very fun set. It's an honor to have both of you taking out your time and singing and dancing, right? Y'all like that?
Yeah, we enjoyed it.
Do y'all like to say something, whole thing? Okay, so like you're in the industry and there's so much talk about the industry. You're in radio and you're a SAG actor. Mm-hmm. So you've been all over, you've been on sets, and you've interviewed some of the people that have been on the best sets as well. Like, what are some of the pros and cons that you have of your own of being in the industry, of what you've seen?
Well, with acting, the pros, and it's sort of both a pro and a con, is technology, because technology has completely changed the face of the industry.
That's true.
Everything, as you would know, everything's moving faster. And I'm not, actually that's something I'm learning, because I'm not someone who is technology advanced. Like I have social media, but I'm not big on it. You know, I'll post everything. I like Instagram a lot because I like to take pictures.
Yeah, we all like Instagram.
But everyone, you know, everything now is self-submission, especially when I moved from LA to Atlanta. Like 90% of my auditions are on tape.
Yep, that's true.
Yeah, and you know, you have to do that yourself, which is awesome because you can create your own opportunities as well.
That's true.
But then it gives you the, you know, you have to be up to date with all that kind of technology.
That's true. Yeah, so. That is true. So that's a pro and a con. Because yeah. at least with the self-tape, you can do yourself several times before you get it versus being in person exactly. where it's like, hey, well, if they like you, they may say do it over again or whatever. But yeah, that's true. That's a pro and a con. What about you and radio?
Radio, it's still the same way it used to be. Mm. It's you submitting your voiceover to see what we call it an air check, to see what you actually sound like. But I know now, piggybacking off what Cody said, social media is everything.
Yeah.
And the pros of social media is easy to be found. It's easy to say, oh, this is that person. Let's work with him or her. You get your following up. But the con is you have people who have thousands of followers
yeah.
and no talent.
Absolutely.
But they get booked because of their following. So Absolutely. That's the con. It's like, oh, it's a pro. You get to see me. Anyone in the world can find me with the right hashtag. But you're not going to book me for my talent. You're going to book someone for their following. So that's the con to it.
It's yeah. the same way with acting. Like you'll
that's
see,
true.
You'll see breakdowns. They want people who have like followings of thousands of people. Yep. And they don't really look at the talent. They look at the followers.
Absolutely. And that just kind of like grinds my gears because you have people that are like really struggling and hustling. I hate the word hustling. That are just working hard toward this thing. And then it's like being in the industry is based on your following or who you're friends with. Not even talent. Like from my field in acting, no shade, no hate on anybody. But when I see a Cardi B book a role because of her following
like the Instagram celebrities,
yes,
the Instagram
yes.
models,
love of hip hop. You just took off. You just get this role on Being Mary Jane. But there's actresses out here with big booties, and that could be just as ghetto and getting character. But they didn't get it because of the following or what yeah. she already has. Like that grinds my gears.
I don't think they look for substance anymore.
No,
it's not substance. Like it's they want to know that they're bringing a follower in.
Absolutely.
Well, following in. They yeah. want to know. Okay, I'm going to book you, and all your followers are going to watch this. They don't yeah. care if the show flops. They just know that the people are going to tune in.
Now that you said something right there. They don't care if it flops because, and then another thing I don't think producers realize is that if you book a Love & Hip Hop or a reality star, period, because I do watch Love & Hip Hop, but if you book a reality star, you got to know that audience follows them for that drama. Now you go and put them on this home base where there's children watching this TV show, like you're gonna lose it. You're gonna right. lose it because they don't care about that. They're gonna just find another person that's their fave and watch it.
Well, in hindsight, I do wanna give a shout out to King Amaya, who actually got casted on the role of Star, the new mm-hmm. hit show,
yeah.
and she's amazing.
Yeah.
A lot of people only knew her from social media and things,
yeah.
but she's acting. I don't know if she took acting courses or whatever, but she really was taken from a social media star. With
King Amaya, which one? This is not the...
King Amaya Scott. She's a transgender.
Mm-hmm. Well, I know she got picked up because she was on Housewives of Atlanta, and then they took her off of that.
I don't think she actually made it to the show. I really don't keep up with the Housewives or whatever.
Yeah.
I know that she was selected to be on there.
Yeah.
But once again, she was selected for her following.
Yeah, she was looking for her following mm-hmm. for that as well. And then when she was removed from Housewives because of some drama, then Lee Daniels took it upon himself to go ahead and give her the opportunity because, of course, he tends to that culture or whatever. And so he sent her to acting classes. So, no, she wasn't. He was not select. He was not an actor. But Lee put her or him in acting classes. So it's kind of like, there you go, you take somebody else, but you know what, you can't knock her because her hustle was hard. Like she was out there and she didn't give up. So you got a chance to be put in classes, whereas there's people that's sitting right here that would love to have that role on Star, you know, that didn't get a
right.
regular actor or actress.
You know, it's funny with a lot of like celebrities and stuff, like Jennifer Lawrence, like one of the biggest celebrities, doesn't have social media. All of the Twilight people, none of mm-hmm. them, like Robert Pattinson and Kristen Stewart, they don't have social media.
Oh,
and
wow.
it can work like where you get in before social media. It's not like, it's not a straight path. It might
right.
be with radio.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, it's very different because sometimes that's what they're looking for. They want a social
right.
media following.
Yeah, right.
Sometimes they want, you know, because acting, it goes to your training, your
yes.
essence, and any good casting director
is gonna
look
because
at that.
Because if you are grandfathered in for your talents, then
yes.
they know who you are. But the new generation coming up, as of right now, you have to have a social media
yeah.
following.
Yeah.
You have to have a presence.
Yeah.
You have to put yourself out there.
Yeah.
There's no way around it. You are not going to get casted in today's, like, you might in some type of way around it, but nine times out of 10, when you fill out your applications for whatever it is, they want to know, what's your social media handles? What are you following? How active are you on these social media pages? They want to know about it. So going forward, I mean, it's a pro and a con, but if you know what the cons are, jump on it.
Yeah.
Get a handle of your social media and expand it.
Which brings my next question. So in your opinion, like for me, I refuse to change who I am.
Correct.
Like, I know what God has for me is for me. However, I do know there are guidelines and there are ways that you have, what things you have to do to get into this industry strict. But are there things that you would do that you will alter about yourself so that you can get to the next level, even in radio?
Oh, I thought about losing weight. But then again, I'm just like, I laugh with my friends all the time because I'm constantly torn to say, ooh, get in shape. But then I say, but you deserve it. And what God has for you is for you, and you're going to make it work. So it's a tear. But at the end of the day, if you want me, you want me.
Yeah,
my talent doesn't change by the size of my waist or how thick my thighs are.
Or you can definitely lose weight.
Just, right.
Then you're on the lemonade diet like Beyonce did back
this
in the day.
This attitude would go berserk.
Yeah, I did the lemonade diet for 10 days and I literally almost fell out. Like number 10, 13, I was like about to pass out. I said I would never do it again. However, I did lose 15 pounds though. You know what I'm saying? 10 days. But it worked. It worked. But how about yourself? Have you thought about altering anything?
Absolutely not. No. The answer to the question is no, especially as an actor, because who I am at home my job is as an actor is to find the essence of the character that's written on the page. And I don't need to alter myself to do that because I am altering myself within the character. Does that make sense? And that has nothing to do with, you know, who I am. But but as an actor, you take pieces of yourself and put pieces of yourself in every single character.
Right.
Like I went to a Q&A with one of the most brilliant actresses ever. Mm. I mean, she's probably going to win an Oscar this season, Viola Davis.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. I went to a How to Get Away with Murder Q&A, and she's always said something that will always stay with me. She said, an actor's job is to be private and public.
That is so true.
Yeah, it always stayed with me because it is, you don't need to necessarily tell them what this is the reasoning, like, because, you know, but yourself, parts of yourself live in that character, and then whatever, you know, fictional things you think of. And it also depends on how you come about it.
Yeah, that's
but,
true.
Yeah, that's, and I love that. I loved what she said.
I love that too. And then that really talks about, have you heard the fact that Atlanta, the new Hollywood Atlanta, however, we are the show off. You know, that's why a lot of us don't make it in Atlanta versus LA. If you look at LA stars or celebrities that have already made it versus Atlanta. Atlanta, we show off. We every time we're on the set, we're good to, hey, we're on set. You know, every time we're with the celebrities, like, oh, we're such and such, but you don't know their name. They haven't even looked you in your eye. They're not going to remember you. You know, like, for me, I don't even take pictures with celebrities unless I'm on the carpet interviewing them. But when I'm with them, I don't take pictures because I want you to know me the next time. When I was on Greenleaf with Oprah and I sat there at the bar playing her friend, people asked, did you get a picture? No, I didn't get a picture. Who asked for a picture with Oprah? What you want to do is say, hey, Oprah, you know, so, like, let's get this conversation going. Let's remember my face. And so I think that's a big difference. In LA, you don't see the Viola Davis or Gabrielle Union or Denzel, especially. You don't see them always on the set waving about, oh, I'm this, I'm that, because it doesn't take that. You'll see it when the movie come out. And so whereas Atlanta, it's like we want to show everything that we're doing the moment of. So, is that because we're trying to prove ourselves to them?
I don't know. I think that's like separating the professional from the groupie. So you get on this set, you do whatever it took to get there. And I personally feel like it's a shot at your professionalism to ask maybe a role model or something, let me get a picture.
Yeah, absolutely.
Me personally, I feel like it belittles you a little. You're on a caliber with me. Instead of holding a conversation, as you said, looking me in my eyes, saying, what can we work on with next? You're like, hey, can I get a picture? Mm-hmm. And it's like, you went from being an equal to being a fan.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. And I went to a SAG event here with the fabulous casting director, Jackie Birch. And she was talking about, she was casting Mother's Day with Julia Roberts.
Uh-huh.
And like one of the local hire actors who had a role, and it was like their first substantial role, they wanted to like get a picture. I think it's the right project. It was with William H. Macy. I know the project, but anyway, so they wanted to get a picture, but she's like, just do the work and let the work speak for yourself.
Yeah,
like, because you can always, I mean, you can always get pictures later. I mean, we put so much emphasis now on social media, like what we were talking about just now, and it's, I don't think it's necessarily like, oh, this makes you a number four. It's just the world we live in now.
It is.
Because everyone wants to record every moment that we're doing, and the celebrities do it themselves. The celebrities take pictures with the celebrities.
With the celebrities.
Because that's what people want to see. You know what I mean?
Yep.
But it's just how we live, and it's fun to get a picture. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that, but it's you're there, and you're as a professional, you're there to do the work.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when I'm on set, I'm there to do the work. You know what I mean?
I know, and then get the check, too.
And I get the check. We'll work for free.
Yeah, you gotta get the check. Well, since we have all this stuff going on, moving on to our next segment is, like, you know, are you serious? There's some things that we see in the industry, especially on social media, or if you're behind the scenes, you see some things going on, that such as the casting couch. Have you guys heard of the casting couch? And have you been a victim of the casting couch? Like, I have. There is a casting director here in Atlanta that is pretty big. And I have yet to get an audition with this casting director because this person asked me out on a date. And I wouldn't go. And I explained, like, you know, hey, I just don't mix that. I don't, because if I ever walk into an audition room and you're there and you're mad because we didn't go to dinner or whatever, you know, it didn't work, then there I am. And you know, he didn't understand that. To this day, I can submit, or my agent or my manager, and I would not get an audition. However, we are still friends or cordial when we see each other. But I understand behind the scenes, that's really what it is, why I haven't gotten an audition with this certain one. So, like, have you ever had that experience when it comes to, like, the casting couch?
Not being too deep off into acting, I don't have that problem. I will say,
going to... like when you went to WTNC, who was your producer over there? He asked you to go on a date.
No, he didn't. I think he was dating someone. He's actually engaged right now.
What about Q over there? He asked you?
No, Q didn't ask me on a date.
What about Enrique?
No, Enrique didn't either.
Okay. You were supposed to have some fellas.
They're handsome. But to each his own, and
you don't like them, y'all watching this, she not saying she don't like y'all, nothing.
See, once again, that's how rumors get started. We gonna shift back to, I didn't have that problem with people trying to be, I'll say mannish to a certain extent with me. When I did meet Q, me and Q met on another project, and we were like dead tired, sweatpants, wiping like the sleep out of our eyes, and we networked and met again at the audition. Everyone else, I'm a Leo. I'm an alpha female, and I feel like I keep it straight. It's one of those things, I'm here about my business. I will never give you that vibe to say, oh, I think she likes me. No, I want this position. If that's not what we're talking about, thank you so much for your time. You know, see you later. So I'm not to say that you gave off some type of flirty. You are very attractive. And any man probably did come after you and say, hey, I would love to take you on a date. But I'm like, business face. Don't get it confused.
Yeah, I agree with that. I agree with that. There are a lot of people that are a lot more friendlier, and I am definitely that one that is so friendly, because I guess to me it's kind of like, I don't really meet people to be like, oh yeah, I like him. Like, I just treat everybody the same.
Our industry's networking.
Yeah, it's networking, and I'm a people person. And I probably do give off that vibe. As a matter of fact, my friends tell me, like, Cheré, well, you're like flirting. I'm not flirting. Like, I don't want him. But from a man or opposite sex, they may take it another way. So that could be. But, you know, when it comes down to it, it's kind of like, no. Like, I don't have a problem saying no either. So, like,
well, I've had people where I've actually had to turn the project down because I thought they were unprofessional, like inviting me out, like, you know, that kind of thing. You know, it's different as a guy. I can imagine it'd be much harder for women to, you know, do that thing. But if you're doing that, it's, you're in a profession that you have to be professional, you know,
right?
What I mean?
Yeah.
Regardless of, like, you want a date or not, you know what I mean? Like, that has nothing to do with the work. It has nothing to do with your talent. And, you know, because back in the day, that's where the casting couch, that's what came from, like, the 50s and 60s.
Yeah.
And, you know, women have come such a long way. Like, even they were talking in the news, the pay gap, the gender pay gap.
Yes.
You know, it's like, we have a long way to go.
Yeah, we do. We're kicking that door down.
Yeah.
I think women are kind of, like, making a statement. So, like,
it's slow
if
but
you,
steady, you know?
Were up for a role on... I don't know, Empire, Scandal, one of the top bros, and they say, hey, Cody, such wants you to go out with them. Or you're in the cast room, they say, hey, let's go out. Like, you're going to, like, the role, should I go out, should I not? Is professionalism going to slide in there, or are you going to?
Professionalism, I mean, that's just my personality. Professionalism always takes it, but
I personally feel like you can counteract it. If it is a role that I'm actually interested in, I feel like I'm gonna give you a dose of your own medicine. You're like, Rainey, let's go get drinks. Sure, meet me at Starbucks at 12 noon. Mm-hmm. It's nothing romantic about Starbucks.
Well, there's a lot of romance that happen around 12 noon right now.
Your 12 noon and my 12 noon might be two different 12 noons. That's completely understandable.
You know, coffee turns some folks on. I don't know.
Listen, but you can't invite them to brunch because mimosas get involved, and that's something different. You need to make sure that it's professional. Oh, can we go out? Sure, I'll set the time and place. Meet me at Starbucks for this. You know, like keeping it open, nothing intimate. So you can turn a negative into a positive. So when they do ask you out to say, let's go get drinks, and you're at Starbucks, and you're like, okay, here's the script. Can you help me with X, Y, Z? And they're going to say, oh, this person is really into this role, instead of coming off and saying no.
Yeah.
And then they can spin it and say, oh, he or she thought I was trying to date them, and I don't need any negativity on my set. Like, flip that negative and make it a positive.
It's very clear. This is a question that's very clear. Either you want the role or you go. So if you have an opportunity to be on one of the biggest radio shows right now, and they say, well, so the producer wants to go out with you, and then once you hear in that coffee conversation what it is, are you gonna go out again, like play with this to get the position, or are you gonna just be like, well, I love that, I miss out?
That's again what God has for me is for me. If that role is meant for me, I'm gonna have it. If not, you know, it might be a fight, I might have to get blacklisted, but I'm not about to lose my soul to gain the world.
And you shouldn't sell yourself up the creek because of something. You know, if your work, you have the talent, the drive to work and do, you know, it's going to come to you. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely.
Like, you don't need to step out and do something that you wouldn't want to do.
That's true.
But you don't want to turn something that's could be just an innocent thing into a big deal.
And exactly.
Then blacklist yourself that way. So it's just weighing your options and, like, you know, deciphering the situation.
Well, then again, if you are blacklisted and nobody hire you, you can always start your own thing, like say something.
Hello.
You're not gonna open a door for me. I'll be in my own door, so come see me.
I love that. I love y'all. See, this is why I have y'all on there, because people be coming on here and they scared to say something. So I ask them the questions to get you out there, because I don't mind singing something. Clearly, the ground is what it is. So is there anything right now on social media that has you going like, are you serious? Like, really, did you just do that? It doesn't have to be industry related. Like, it's so much out there. Like, something that you just saw that was kind of like, wow, really?
I wish the butt shots will die down. Yeah. Like, the every picture you're scrolling through and the thirst trap pictures.
Yep.
I kind of wish that they would leave that in 2016. Yeah. I get tired of scrolling and maybe my mom looks over my shoulder and it's like a little fluffy bottom on there.
Yeah, that drives my gears too. Yeah. Oh, lots of grinding gears. That was one of two. Yeah. That and the twerk.
Yeah. Let me tell you. I know for a fact it's a difference between trashy and tasteful.
Yes.
I've seen some tasteful nudes and I've seen some trashy nudes. I've seen some tasteful taking a picture with a towel or something that was like, oh, this is beautiful. It's art. And I've seen some, girl.
Yeah, I've seen them too. A whole bunch of them.
Yeah.
But then people are going to argue with you and say that's their art.
Right.
You know what I mean?
And I'm over it.
Like, I'm
and then you're like,
Beyonce. Like that trash versus trash.
Well, Beyonce, I don't care exactly. About yeah, I don't like, either. Like,
wait, trash. What,
she did the same thing Kim K did. Beyonce's little naked, all that. The same thing Kim K, but hers was just lifted up, glory, and the sun came out.
Because you got the beehive behind it.
Yeah.
It was kind of tacky to me.
Trash is trash. Yeah, it was tacky. I think it was very tacky. Did you see it? Okay, you
she does have her pros and cons though, like her performance at the Grammys.
You know what?
Amazing. Though,
I was just talking about this. You know, Beyonce, because she's a visionary and artist, she's changed. If you look at her from the beginning, she's changed to become more theatrical.
Yeah, she is.
Because I saw her at the Georgia Dome. I saw her with the videos and stuff. She didn't used to do that. Like, if you look crazy in love, it was just it was just a music video.
Yep.
You know, and now it had like the whole Lemonade concept album. You know, it was a concept, and it was created by her, and had all these beautiful visuals and the poetry and the stories.
Absolutely.
And she used her daughter and Serena Williams and.
Yeah, but Serena, what was Serena doing in there? She was that's what we just got done saying. So I'm not even about to.
Hey, Beyonce, tell you to do something, you do it.
No, Beyonce, get her life.
I want to twist your gears a little, Beyonce fan.
Okay.
Do you not think she can dibble dab with demonic and voodoo type things?
No, I don't. I mean, people say that she's the Illuminati.
The Beyonce fan, nothing.
I need to know. You know, like you got to get it from the horse's mouth because it's just.
But like, anytime someone does something that is that artistic and you mm-hmm. have that platform,
yeah.
it's gonna cause some stirs, you know. And
yeah.
always, no matter who it is, they've been saying that about Gaga. They've been saying that about Katy Perry.
Illuminati.
They say. Yeah, the Illuminati, and whether that's real or not, I mean, we'll either find out or we won't. But I think she does what she envisions, because people were saying that about, you know, she dressed in the gold with the god, like she was
yeah.
being a god. But I think it was just her, you know, she's pregnant, you know, she's carrying twins.
There's plenty
of
outfits she could have picked. She's pregnant. It's a lot of terms stuff out there. But it's okay, Cody. I mean, it's okay. Cody is a Beyonce. He's a beehive. It's fine. We love it. We love it. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll be right back. We're going to take a commercial and then we'll come back. We're not talking about Beyonce all night, though. That's right, it's Industry Beat Talk. So you've heard us all day. We've been talking about the industry and everything that goes on. Well, now we have the rapper and the actor, Lil Zane himself, in the building. Put your hands together for Lil Zane. Thank you so much. Welcome to my set. Welcome here on Say Something with Cheré. I'm doing good. Thank you. That little walk you did out there, that was cute. That was fly. That wasn't even cute. That was fly.
You know, I practiced that all night. You know, I was coming on the show, so I was like, you know, I got to make sure the introduction's everything.
I'm sad because people don't realize you say something when you ain't saying nothing, right? So when you see me walking,
yeah,
talk, it's
yeah.
you saying something. Because
yeah.
your kicks are nice. They saying something, too.
You know? I see you over here, too. You swear it out.
Well, you know me. What? Where? What you talking
about?
Yeah,
you
yeah. You know, I had to make sure they gave us our shoe cam. You know,
that's
you know.
A boss right there. You know, that's a boss. I like
but
that.
You know, it's funny you say that because I don't like to be referred to as a boss. You know what? Because a boss tells people what to do. I'd rather be a leader. See, now you know what? For as a man, I guess that would work.
It's either you telling somebody what to do or you being told what to do. Which one you want to do?
Well, I want to be a leader. I want to take people with me. I want to show them what
like
to
just
do.
Capture something. You like being told what to do. See, I can.
Side. See, you can't. No,
see,
no, you're not about to.
No,
see, that's the problem with you fellas now. You want to tell me, but you know one thing, you can't tell me what to do. No, I do know how to listen. I take instruction. I do.
See, that's
it might cost
talking.
You a purse or bag.
I follow instructions. You got to know, even a boss has to know when to take instructions and listen.
Absolutely.
So when I say boss, I mean it in like the most, you just got your stuff together, you know?
Thank you.
Diva. Just can't say diva?
You can say whatever. Thank you. That'll work
diva.
Too. Boss diva. A real boss can put it in those terms. And so thank you for breaking it down. Because most people just say boss. They just boss. They think they're up here. And
boss lady.
Thank you. You boss better keep. I'm just going to sit back and let you talk. Go ahead. Keep.
That's the boss lady.
It's the boss lady. And, you know.
I'm here for her. I'm here for her.
They don't want to hear about me. They want to hear about you. So you've been in the game forever. And this is Industry Beat Talk. And so now you're kind of just like coming back out. You have a history with collabing with some of the greatest that's out there.
Yeah.
112, definitely. We like that. You got that. Little,
right
yes.
There. That's always the best right there, 112.
Of course. Yeah, you got some with Snoop Dogg, though. You kind of out there with everybody. Yeah. So right now you have a new album coming out. Life I Live. Life I Live. So what's different from back then to now?
I think really what's different is just, you know, of course I grew up. Got more to talk about, been through more, you know, I think when I first came out, I was just experiencing, I was just going through life, but now I'm doing movies, I'm traveling the world, you know, I got some children now, I got kids, so.
You a daddy?
Yeah.
You mean to say I got some money now?
Got
you know, here's what you really
now,
wanted
you know,
to say. I know.
You know, I'm bossed up.
You know, bossed up.
So now I'm talking about boss stuff, you know, this album, Life I Live, I just wanted it. You know, people say, well, you're going to change the L-I-L in your name, Lil Zane. And so I just gave it a meaning, like Life I Live Zane.
Nice. I didn't catch that.
Yeah, Life I Live Zane, kind of L-I-L.
So you'll take Lil Zane? You'll
yeah,
keep
you know,
it?
But my pops is Big Zane. You know what
okay,
I mean?
Okay, so yeah.
So, and people don't know, like my grandma called me Lil Zane. You know what I'm saying?
Hey.
5'5", you know, still a boss. You know what I'm saying? I'm standing on my money like 7.
Ah.
You know what I mean? But so it's always Lil Zane. You know what I mean?
And
I think,
I'm that.
I think it's just part of staying humble.
Yes.
You know, if my pops was to pass away, Lord forbid, knock on wood.
Don't touch it. That ain't wood, but knock on it anyway, child. Yeah, there it is.
But if anything was to happen, you know, I feel like then I step up when I got to be Big Zane. But right now, I enjoy being Lil Zane. I enjoy being young. you know, still able to make mistakes and grow from them.
You know what? That is very important that you say that, because that's what we talk about in the industry. This industry beat talk, you just said something about staying humble and remaining who you are, regardless of what people say, it's time for you to grow up from Lil Zane to Zane. Yeah. That's something that's really big. Have you noticed that, and how have you, well, you just told me how you dealt with it, but how do you see, how did you deal with it when people telling you you should be one way, but you already know?
I'm a big kid, so a lot of times, I hate the fact I got to grow up. You know what I'm saying? I think everybody hates the fact they got to grow up. Like, and I think everybody, no matter how old you get, still got that kid inside of them. And I just still have, I think the thing with me is, and I can see you probably have it too, is just that drive. Like, no matter how old we get or how wiser we get, you still got that drive, like that that eagle's eye. You got your focus on what you want. I think long as you find that kid inside you and you keep that passion for whatever it is you have a passion for, I think that's what keeps you young and keeps you living. And, you know, somebody told me the other day, like, I'm just trying to enjoy life. I'm like, you know what, you gotta live life before you can enjoy it.
Exactly. Or you just exist and you just here.
Some people play basketball, but some people love and like enjoy playing basketball.
Exactly.
So before you can enjoy life, you gotta live it.
Exactly. You're just living it.
Yeah.
It's not even about everything, the fame that comes with it. You're just living it because you enjoy it.
I'm gonna enjoy it 20 years from now when my kids is straight and me and you sitting on a yacht somewhere.
You better talk it. I can see it.
Weed is legalized and I could just blow in front of the police. You know what I mean?
Yep.
That's enjoying life.
Exactly. You know? That's enjoying. And I like shoes and purses and stuff with my name on them, my label.
Yeah.
Like, I can, you know what? You got vision. It's in them glasses. I can see your vision.
Yes. But you can also, I'll take the glasses off for you. You can just see the passion.
I can look in your eyes. Boy, you better stop playing with me on this here set, because I have them cut in heart. Look.
You
gotta have passion. If you don't have passion, you have nothing.
Yeah.
So in the industry, because it takes a while to get to where you are now. Mm-hmm. You know, even myself, it takes a while to get to where you are. You gotta have passion, you gotta have patience as well. Yes. So what is one thing that you see people make that mistake in the industry?
I think people make the mistake when they stop when you stop acting like it's your first time. Every time I go on stage, every interview I do, every time I do a movie, I act like it's my first one. And like I never did it before.
I feel you on that. Yeah. I'm the same way.
I'm just as nervous on every set or every song I do. I'm just as anxious to do it, just like if I was the first song I ever did.
So they should keep those bubble guts.
Yeah.
Keep
that passion. Keep that excitement. Like,
yeah.
And keep young people around you.
Like that's true.
My whole crew
that's
is
true.
Like babies. Like they like 18, 19. Still drinking out of bottles, you know what I'm saying?
See?
Like, but they got the ideas.
Yeah.
They got the ideas. They all probably taller than me, too. They, like,
I'm sure
14.
That.
They, like, 6 feet tall.
Well, yeah, that's what's in the water.
I just keep a bunch of young people around me, and just because they full of new ideas.
That's true.
And young and hungry people. Cause
hungry, that's the key.
You can still be 25, 30, but if you hungry, I can roll with you. If you're not hungry or you're not young with that spirit, and just I can't.
You can't roll with it. Yeah. So the best advice you can give is to stay hungry, stay humble.
Stay hungry, stay keep the youth around you.
And keep the young people around you.
Know what's going on.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? How else you going to learn all the new dances? Like, how you going to be able to twerk and do all the other stuff and all the other dances?
Like,
how about
like,
that? But you know them all, though, right?
You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Cool.
Juju on the beat, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you know what they really wearing that when I, but I just learned how to do it, so I don't feel bad.
These kids don't know this scrappy song. They don't know that. You know. Study a lesson, man.
So listen, are we going to be dancing to a life of...
Life I Live.
Are we going to dance to that? It's going to be something in there for us to cut up?
You're going
to
dance, you're going to think, you're going to cry, you're going to smile, you're going to...
You're going to make babies?
You know what I'm saying? But, you know, it's for 18 and up, you know?
Cool, that's what's up.
18 and up, definitely.
Well, I'm definitely over 18, so... I don't look forward to having. How many kids do you have before
I
did you
I
go?
I have three.
You have three kids.
Three babies, yeah.
Boys, girls.
Two boys and a girl.
Two boys and a girl.
Yeah.
Not married, apparently. Still single, on the market. If anybody's looking for him before he leaves my set.
I'm married to the music, man.
You're married to the music. Okay, right, so he's not available then. Well, I just want to say thank you so much for stopping by. You want to tell everybody where they can find you and when does the album release?
The album comes out sometime this summer, and you know, you can find me Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Lil Zane's World, and LilZane'sWorld.com. You know?
Lil Zane World.
Yeah.
Lil Zane's World, that's it. You just say Google you, they'll find you.
Google me.
All over the place. Well, thank you so much for stopping by and saying something. You want to go ahead and just give the people a little nugget, a little something positive advice from Lil Zane's world.
A little positive advice from Lil Zane's world. I would say, you know, stay focused. Don't let nobody get you down. Keep people around you that have your best interest in mind. And just have fun with it, whatever you're doing. Once it's not fun, stop doing it.
That's good.
If something's not fun to me, I stop. I don't want to do it.
I think I'm going to be like 120 still on the set. What? Yeah. It's going to be a forever fun.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much. We'll be right back again. This is Lil Zane. Go ahead and follow him. Look out for the album coming out this summer.
Yeah.
And there you have it, Industry Beat Talk, right here on Say Something with your girl Cheré, my boy Cody. Thank you so much for coming out.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
You are so welcome. You've been a blast. And of course, the country cutie, Rainey Kate.
I told you I'm going to have everybody into the show, boo. Thanks for having me.
Thank you so much for coming out. It's been fun. I so appreciate you guys. But before you leave my set, please tell them where they can find you.
Social media, my name, simple, Cody Carrera, no spaces. I'm on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, and Facebook.
You can find me on Instagram at Country Cutie Kate.
There it is. Now, you know where to find them, but they're just not in the industry. He's not just an actor, and she's just not a radio host. They're actually the people that are living life every day like you. So go ahead and give them a nugget to living life.
Never compromise being yourself, because whoever's supposed to love you is going to love you just the way you are.
Love it.
Be who God created you to be. Do what you love. Love, art, and peace.
There you have it. And did you catch my girl shoes? Like, she came on this set hurting them, like saying something with these boots all the way up. They're thigh highs, right?
Girl, you see me.
Yes! With the nice dress. There you have it. If you want to get on Say Something, you know, hit us up on our email. Again, thank you so much for watching us and streaming with us and saying something. Everybody's